Hello guys, I am engineer Muhammad Adnan Khan and you are watching my YouTube channel Being Engineer. Our today's topic is why stirrups are provided in concrete beam. Before we proceed to our topic, we need to understand what are stirrups. Then we will discuss why these stirrups are provided in concrete beam and what is shear reinforcement and the purpose of shear reinforcement in beam. So actually there are two types of reinforcement in beam. Number one, long straight bar is also called as longitudinal bar placed along the length of a beam. The other type of reinforcement is stirrup. What is stirrup? Closed loop of small dia bars at regular intervals along the length of a beam is called as stirrup. As you can see in this picture, the long bars or the main bars are called longitudinal reinforcement bars, and the bars that you can see in square shape are provided at regular intervals. These bars are called as stirrups. Now there are two types of failures that can occur in a beam. First one is flexural failure. What is flexural failure? The beam sags or bends under increased loading, which results in flexural failure. Therefore, longitudinal bars are provided to resist tension due to flexure. So, the main purpose of longitudinal bar is to provide resistance against tension due to flexural or bending. As you can see in this picture, longitudinal cracks are flexural failure that occur in the central span of the beam. As you can see in this picture, the cracks appear in the middle section of the beam. To avoid these cracks, longitudinal bars are provided to resist tension due to flexure. The other type of failure that can occur in a beam is shear failure. A shear crack may develop which is inclined at 45 degree to the horizontal, and it develops at mid depth near the support, grows toward the top and bottom. Shear failure is brittle and therefore must be avoided. So stirrups are provided to resist such shearing action and also prevent the longitudinal bars from bending outward. As you can see in this picture, the shear cracks appear near the end supports or near the columns and are inclined at 45 degree angle. So to avoid these types of cracks, stirrups are provided. It is necessary to mention here that we see in normal practice that the spacing between the stirrups near the ends or supports is very less. The spacing between the stirrups is very less as compared to central portion, because the cracks, the shear cracks appear near the end supports, and to avoid these cracks, to avoid shear failure, stirrups are provided. So what is the difference between stirrups and ties? Stirrups. The term stirrups are usually applied to the lateral reinforcement in flexural members. What are flexural members? The beam is actually flexural member which is subjected to bending. Ties. The term ties usually applied to the lateral reinforcement in vertical compression members. What is compressional member? That is a column. As you can see in this picture, in case of beam, this reinforcement which is in the shape of a rectangle is called as stirrup, and similar reinforcement in case of column is called as ties. The purpose of both stirrup and ties are more or less the same. So the purpose or usage of stirrup. Stirrups are provided to hold the longitudinal bars together in an RCC beam. So the main purpose of stirrup is to hold the longitudinal bars in its position. It increases the compressive strength of the column. So in case of columns, ties increase the compressive strength of column. In beams, they prevent diagonal cracks or inclined cracks due to shear, so we provide stirrups as shear reinforcement. It can improve the ductility of column. In case of column, the ties improve the ductility of column. At the time of concreting, it prevent movement of main reinforcement to provide lateral confinement to the longitudinal bars. The primary reason for the diagonal shear is due to compression and tension caused by the transverse and vertical tension. Eventually, diagonal tension occurs since concrete is stronger in compression as compared to tension. This tension is bound by steel stirrup which holds the cracked surface together. They are usually placed in places where there are high chances of shearing, such as beneath large loads and bearing points. It provides resistance against the shear and torsion. It keeps longitudinal bars intact during construction. It prevents premature buckling of individual bars. So guys, that's all for today. If you are not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe it and press the bell icon so that you can get my latest informative and updated videos.